Good morning, Good Hope Missionary Baptist Church. Once again, we have come together to worship and praise our Lord. We want to thank you, those that have come together in the sanctuary, and those of you in Lively. Today it is March 24th in the year of 2024. We thank the Lord for bringing us together on one accord. I'll read to you Psalms 95th chapter. Oh, come, let us sing unto the Lord. Let us make a joyful noise to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving and make a joyful noise unto him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hands are the deep places of the earth. The strength of the hills is his also. The sea is his and he has made it. In his hands are formed the dry land. Oh, come, let us worship and bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is our God and we are his people. Of his pasture and the sheep of his hands. Today, if you hear his voice, harden not your heart. Amen. I'll turn it over to the minister of music.
Yeah, it slipped on me. Amen. Bless the Lord. So good to be here. Amen. It's good to be seen and good to see. Somebody say amen. God is worthy of our praise, amen. Come on, let's give God a hand of praise, amen. We already down to the end of March, amen. And we still here, amen. Is that y'all hand of praise to God? Okay, if that's your best, I just say okay, amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord. I wanna thank you, Lord, you've been so good. Yes, you have. Oh, you've been so good. You've been so I wanna thank you, Lord. I can't hear you. You saved my soul. Even though I didn't deserve it, you saved my soul. Lord, you saved my soul, and I just want to thank you, Lord, for every time that you protected me, and I didn't know what to do. I want to say thank you, and how you loved me and cared for me when I didn't do the same. I want to say thank you. And I'll be praising you and thanking you for the rest of my life. How I come to know the meaning of your love and sacrifice. I appreciate all that you do. Mm. I wanna say thank you. I wanna say thank you. Thank you, Lord, for saving me. Thank you, Lord, for keeping me. Thank you, Lord, for bringing me through. Lord, I thank you for my son, too. Come on, give God a praise. Good morning, Reverend. Look like you got some new eyes. They say, looked at my hands and they look new. Say, looked at my feet and they did too. And God is so good, you can get some new eyes. Come on, give God a praise up in here. Lord, you know that I'm your child. And I'm doing the best that I can. Though my ways get so hard, you know I just don't understand. Oh Lord, I need you to hold right now. Oh Lord, I need you. As I travel from place to place, oftentimes I'm treated so bad, but it's my determination. I can't miss a friend that never had. Oh Lord, I need you to hold my hand right now. Oh Lord, I need you. I got one more verse and I'm gonna let him in there. I'm gonna continue to run for Jesus, even if I have to run all alone, because it's my determination to make God's heaven my beautiful home. Oh Lord, I need you to hold my hand. I can't make it without you, Lord. Oh, Lord. Yeah. Let me bring this witness in here.
I'm going to continue to run for Jesus, even if I have to run alone, because it's my determination to make God's beautiful heaven my home. Oh Lord,
I need you to hold my hand
right now. Oh Lord, I need you to hold my hand.
Hold me,
Jesus. Hold me, Jesus. 'Cause if you don't hold me, I will surely fall. I need you, Jesus. Come on, y'all, and hold me. Can you rock me?
Rock us.
Oh, Jesus. Come on and rock me.
Hold me.
Oh, my Jesus.
Jesus.
Oh, rock me.
Hold me.
Come on and rock me.
Jesus.
My Jesus. Come on, Jesus.
Oh, Jesus. You don't hold me, I surely fall, Lord. I need you to hold me.
Hold me,
Jesus.
Hold me, Jesus.
My mama loved me.
My Jesus.
but she can't hold me. My daddy gonna hold me, and he can't hold me. But I know you, Jesus,
hold me.
You can hold me.
Hold me.
You can mold me.
Hold me.
You can do it, Lord.
Hold me.
With my back against the wall, all I had to do was call.
Hold me.
You just hold me.
Hold me.
Hold me, Jesus.
Hold
listen,
me.
I thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Jesus. I thank you, Lord.
I thank you, Lord.
I thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
Jesus. I thank you, Lord.
I thank you, Lord.
I thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Hey, thank you, Lord.
Thank you, listen. Lord.
Lord, I know you've been so good. Lord, I know you've been so good. You watch
over me.
All night.
All night long. Lord, I know you've been so good.
Amen. Thank you.
When I think about Jesus, what he done for me. When I think about Jesus, how he set me free. Day and then, hey, all night. Listen, I gotta praise. Come on, all over the building. I gotta praise. Hey, I gotta praise. Hey, hey. I gotta pray. Yeah. Ooh, ain't he good? Ain't he good, y'all? And ain't nothing like Holy Ghost exercise. Ain't nothing like a Holy Ghost party. Amen. When the Spirit of God is dwelling in the building, I'm not talking about the building, but I'm talking about the city of your soul. When you can feel God moving. Come on, Reverend. Come on, Reverend. I'm just telling y'all, God is so good. Can I tell y'all something? Y'all know I've been trying to work, and you know I had no business working, right? Because you know God called me in the ministry, right? And I'm doing everything. Come on, Kim, but go into the ministry, amen? So I was at work, and every time I went to work, every time I go in there, was a hostile environment. And I'm like, I just don't fit in this situation. And God said, if you're going to choose the money, are you going to choose me? And I had to tell him, if you say you got me, then I got to trust and believe that you will make a way out of no way. Turn my midnight. So I say all of that to say, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm free. Oh, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm free. I can sing it now. I'm free. Praise the Lord. I'm free. No longer bound. No more chains holding me. I am. My mama's soul is resting. Oh, it's just a blessing.
Resting.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I'm free.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
I'm free.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Y'all sing it with me.
Hallelujah.
Y'all sing it with me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah is the highest praise. Hallelujah. Sing it with me now. Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
I'm free.
I'm free. For freeing me.
Yes, sir.
Took me a long time
well,
to just trust in the Lord. all this singing I be doing, and God had to ask me, Kim, do you trust me enough? Do you believe that I'll take care of you? Oh yeah, I had to make up my mind one more time and say, I'm sorry, Lord, I'm sorry. Praise the Lord. I don't want nothing to take me from you, God. Nothing from my ministry, God. Lord, 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 Lord. I don't want to have to ignore my ministry to just go to work. You said you would supply all my needs. My gift will make room for me. I got to trust and believe in your word like everybody else. I know you will do it, do it, do it, do it. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm free. Well, I hate to kind of stick in my face. My God. Come on,
you do know that the Lord is good. You do know that the Lord woke you up this morning. You do know that he put food on your table. You do know that he put clothes on your back. You do know that he held back all hurt, harm, and danger just to get you here. I feel the presence of the Lord in this place. And I know you're ready to praise him. I know you're ready to worship him. I know you're ready to say, Lord, here I am. Do I have a witness? Amen. You do know what today is, don't you? You do know it's Palm Sunday, don't you? Out of all the days of the year, D. Huh? Out of all the days of the year. If you've never praised him all year long, you got your day right now. Do I have a witness? And let me add to this. You can praise him for you. You can praise him for those who are not here. Do I have a witness? You can praise him for what he's done, for what he's doing, and what he's going to do. Amen. This is the day that the Lord has made. And we shall rejoice and be glad in it. I don't know about you, but I'm glad about the fact that we're here today. Yes. Amen. Tomorrow's not promised to us. Amen. But we're here today. Bow your heads and close your eyes as we go to God in prayer. Most holy, eternal God, our Father, we thank you for holding the reins. We thank you, O gracious God, for electrifying the air that we might be able to enter into your presence with praise and thanksgiving. Father, as we come together as praying brothers and sisters, we ask, O gracious God, that you meet our every need. We know you can and we know you will. Father, I heard somebody say, if you did it then, you can do it now. Have thine own way. You are a good God. You've been better to us than we have been to ourselves. So, Lord, we ask you now in the name of Jesus, go into the hospitals, go into the byways and the highways. Father, have thine own way. Somebody somewhere in this world do not know you and in the pardoning of their sins, and they do not know you, dear Lord, as your as their personal Savior. But God, we ask now in the name of Jesus, move us in their way. Make us a stumbling block for them, that they may hear, see, and feel the Lord on the altars of their hearts. Let us open up our minds, our mouths, to be able to carry the gospel unto them and to tell them that you are a sinner. We all are sinners. But if you confess the Lord Jesus today, thou shalt be saved. Lord, we ask in the name of Jesus that you have thine own way. Lord, we ask that you go to those who are in bereavement right now. Lord, comfort their spirits, comfort their hearts. We pray for the Harris family and the Martinez family. God, we know you got them. We thank you, dear Heavenly Father, for the life of Adriana Martinez. Lord, we know you. We know where she is today, and we say thank you. So now come, O gracious God, and let us worship you together. Fill this place with your train. Electrify the atmosphere with the power of your spirit. Somebody may leave here today knowing, dear Heavenly Father, that they just got a closer walk with you. And Lord, we say thank you. Have thine own way, O God. Have thine own way. God, now we ask in the name of Jesus that you take this, your humble servant, hide me in the shadow of the cross. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart, let it be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. It is in the name of an almighty God that we pray. Amen and amen. Come on, put those hands together. Put those hands together. Hallelujah. 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 There is a word from the Lord. There is a word from the Lord. Amen. Before I go on any further, I want to say to Good Hope, thank you for yesterday. Amen. I was very proud of what God has put in your spirit as a vessel, and certainly as a church of hope, that you have showed, that you showed love and compassion on the Harris family. Amen. 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 Thank you so very much to the hospitality committee. Amen. To those who are in their places. Amen. And we even had security from Vicksburg, Mississippi. Huh? Amen. And we enjoyed ourselves in the Lord. It was good to see, amen, so many people we hadn't seen in a while. But as I said, we know where Adri is right now. Amen. And she is shouting with joy. There is a word from the Lord. I asked the Lord on this morning, Lord, how do you want me to handle this one today? Amen. Everybody know that this is Palm Sunday, and oftentimes we sometimes miss what God intends for us to receive on this day. But he gave me a couple of verses for us to look at. Amen. First of all, I want you to look at Luke chapter 19, where we have the narrative of him coming into, amen, Jerusalem on this day. I'm not going to read all of it in your spare time. Go to Luke 19, and read it thusly. I'll lift up just a few verses there in Luke 19. And then thumb your way to John, the 12th chapter, and the 16th verse. So we're looking at Luke 19. Amen. And we'll start in Luke 19. A few verses starting at the 34th verse, and then going to John, the 12th chapter. If you have it, say amen. Amen. Luke 19, verse 34. And they said unto him, the Lord hath need of him. And they brought him to Jesus, and they cast their garments upon the colt, and they set Jesus thereon. And as he went, they spread their clothes in the way. And when he was come nigh, even now at the descent of the Mount of Olives, the whole multitude of the disciples began to rejoice and praise God with a loud voice, and with all the mighty works that they had seen, saying, blessed be the King that cometh in the name of the Lord, peace in heaven and glory in the highest. And some of the Pharisees from among them said unto him, Master, rebuke thy disciples. And he answered them and said unto them, I tell you that if these would hold their peace, the stones would immediately cry out. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Amen. Flip over where you have your thumb or your finger. Let's go to John 16. And John 16 simply says, these things understood not the disciples at the first, but when Jesus was glorified, then remembered they that these things were written of him, And that they had done these things unto him. Amen. For a few moments, I want to talk about you got it with a question mark. Huh? You got it? You got it? You got it? With a question mark. Amen. Let's go to the benediction. Amen. I'm sorry. Y'all looking at me like, what? But I got to tell you something about you got it. Amen. The story is told about a young little girl. She was out in the yard playing and having fun. And then her mother came to the door, called to her, said, Sally, I need you to come into the house. And Sally said, why? Mama said, well, when you come into the house, you'll see, you'll find out. She kept on playing, she kept on playing, and Mama came back to the door and said, Sally, it's time to come in the house. And Sally again said, why, Mama? She said, when you come in, you'll find out. Sally came in the house. Mama went in the kitchen and called Sally into the kitchen. She said, Sally, I need you in the kitchen. Sally again says, why? She said, when you come in the kitchen, you find out. Amen. She said, just sit here on the stool and watch me. And then Sally said, why? Sally watching. Mama went to the cupboard and pulled out a pan. Mama went to the cupboard, pulled out flour. Went to the cupboard, put out sugar. Went to the cupboard and pulled out some things and started whipping it up. Poured the batter into the pan. And Sally was sitting there wondering, I wonder why. Mama put it in the oven. Sally wanted to go back outside, but Mama said, no, just sit there. Sally said, why? Sally said, why? Mama said, you'll see after a while. Amen. So after about a few minutes, Mama pulled out the pan. Within the pan, there was a cake, and Mother decorated the cake. Sally said, Mama, why are you doing that? And then Mama said, well, just keep sitting there. You'll find out. And it dawned on Sally that Mama had just baked her birthday cake. And then after Mama got finished doing what she had to do, she looked at Sally and she said, Sally, you got it? So today there's a lot of things going on in the spirit realm, and based on our knowledge of what Jesus did this day, do I have a witness? Somebody got to say, you got it. Amen. You already know the story. You already know the story that Jesus is on his way to Jerusalem for the very last time. And all the things that he did, everything that he was doing on his way to Jerusalem, he had the disciples with him. He had those followers with him. And with all the miracles that he performed, amen, and all the teachings that he did, in a way, Jesus had to turn to the disciples and to the multitudes and ask them, you got it? Amen. Everything they saw Jesus do, they didn't quite understand, because he was on his way to Jerusalem. And we know all week long, next week, there's going to be some things going on in the spirit realm, in that spiritual Jerusalem, that folk will not understand. But ever since I've been saved, ever since I've known God, ever since I've come to this relationship of understanding what Jesus did, amen, in Jerusalem from today and next week, Amen. I've come to realize that he did it for me.
All right.
Yeah, Deacon Bell said for us, but I can't speak for us. I can only speak for me. Amen. And every time I realize what God did through Jesus on this week, I'm here to tell you that every time, every year, amen, there may be one, there may be two incidents that I find out that Jesus opens doors for someone this week.
Amen.
And I look forward to it. I look forward to it from today all the way to next Sunday. I'm looking for Jesus to show me something in the spirit. I may not witness it with my eyes, but I may hear it with my ears that the Lord has done something. Miraculous for somebody this week. It may not be as big as you think it ought to be. Amen. Somebody been looking for a job, but next week they gonna get it. Somebody has been looking for a new report from the doctor, a better report from the doctor. Amen. And all month long they have been wondering and antagonizing about what the doctor gonna say. But on next week, the tide is going to turn. Do I have a witness? It may be something small. It may be something small. Your money may be funny and your change may be strange. But next week, it's going to be all right. Do I have a witness? So we find Jesus. We find Jesus in Jerusalem, heading towards Jerusalem. Amen. For the very last time. And in preparation for Jesus to enter into Jerusalem, somebody has got to get it. I don't know how he's going to give it to you. Amen. But I need you to understand, you're going to get it. Some way, somehow, you're going to get it.
Amen.
And when you read the account of the preparation for this jubilant parade that's going to go forth, you're going to find out that there is some preparations that had to be made before he started his trip, amen, into Jerusalem. You see how he taught before he got on the road to Jerusalem. You could see how he performed miracles on the road to Jerusalem. All along the way, Jesus is performing miracles and changing people's lives.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And in the midst of the journey, it have to appear or have to occur, amen, that Jesus had not made any preparations for the feast that was going to take place in Jerusalem. Have you ever been there? Have you ever been anticipating a event and all of a sudden you realize I hadn't made any preparations? Amen. But I'm here to tell you, amen, preparations will be made. The Passover is coming in Jerusalem, and Jesus and the disciples and the multitudes have not made preparations. There's no unleavened bread. There's no kosher meat. Nothing to prepare for the celebration. And when we read in Luke 19, we find out, amen, that the text informs us that as they drew near to Bethpage and Bethany, at the foot of the Mount of Olives, he sent two of his disciples ahead, saying unto them, go into a village, and you're going to find a colt tied. Amen. And when you get there, don't talk to nobody. You're on your mission. You're on your mission. I gave you your mission. Loose the coat and bring him here.
Yes.
And this is where we have to focus in on what Jesus is about to do there in Bethpage and Bethany before he gets to Jerusalem. Amen. Within the journey, there's two unknown disciples. And we know at this point he had 12. But all of a sudden, amen, the synoptic gospels do not name these disciples. And there's a reason for that, and the reason is that we don't know. Amen. But the fact of the matter is, it was just two of them that he gave the instructions to go get the coat, loose him, and bring him here. It didn't matter. It didn't matter what they had on their minds. It didn't matter, amen, what they wanted to do. It didn't matter. And what struck me was that there's no written evidence that they refused to do it. Amen. Obedient. Y'all know this is better than sacrifice. And all Jesus told them to do was go. Amen. And when they went, they had to have the declaration to whoever they fought, whoever they sought. Amen. After they would loosen the coat. Amen. Jesus said, if anybody asks you what you're doing, tell them, here it is, the Lord has need of it. You got it? Huh? The Lord has need of it. I wish that you would, with your sanctified minds, let's eavesdrop. Yes. On that conversation between those two disciples. Amen. Jesus said, go. And if anybody asks you what you're doing, tell them the Lord have need of it. Here they go. They're walking to Jerusalem. One afraid to say something to the other one because he didn't get it. He didn't quite understand. Amen. But in our sanctified mind, let's drop in on this conversation. Everybody else back there with Jesus. One looked to the other. I wonder why he chose us to go loose this coat and bring him here. I wonder. And I see the other one saying, well, I really don't know. But I know I wasn't going to say I wasn't going to do it. Do I have a witness? And the other one get really inquisitive because he really wants to know. He don't own no transportation. He didn't figure out what we needed for the Passover. We only about maybe 5 miles from Jerusalem, and we didn't been walking around the region for a long time. But now we got to go and pretty much steal a donkey. And he tells us that if anybody asks us what we're doing, he told us just say that the Lord has need of him. Amen. But you know what? I'm glad that he chose us for this mission because maybe when we find the coat, amen, that he really wants us to ride it back to the group. He didn't give us any other instructions, so it got to be for transportation. Amen. You get it? The conversation is that they don't know why Jesus asked them to go get this donkey and bring it back to him. They don't know. Jesus didn't say anything about the fact that I want to do this, what I want to do that. All he said, if anybody asks you, stop you and ask you what y'all doing with this donkey, the only thing you need to tell them is that the Lord has need for it. I wonder this morning, is there anybody in the house who look to yourself as being an instrument of the Lord? And can you declare to those who watch in your life, and can you declare to those, amen, who wondering about who you are and whose you are, can you declare with your mouth, the Lord has need of me? You don't know. Amen. The Lord may send somebody your way that asks of you, can you help? Huh? Will you declare the Lord has need of me? Amen. And in your helping, in your assistance, do you know that the Lord is depending on you to do just what he asks you to do? Amen. Whether you don't get it or not. Amen. God is saying there is some sacrifices in our lives that we have got to render to him. And I'm here to tell somebody it's worth the sacrifice. Because of what he did for us, because of what he gives us and how he blessed us, the sacrifice is worthy. But oftentimes you find people not wanting to go through the sacrifice. They put themselves and their agenda before God and before the mission that Jesus has given unto them. Do I have a witness? Why? Because they don't have it. They don't understand exactly that God put us here under the personage of Jesus Christ. Amen. To be able to tell the world, for God I live and for God I die. Amen. Oftentimes I have a conversation with the Lord, and like others, I don't get disillusioned, but sometimes I ask the Lord, amen, Lord, why? People say, you're not supposed to question the Lord, but how are you going to know what the Lord has for you and what God wants you to do, amen, for his son Jesus? How are you going to know if you don't ask the question? And sometimes I see that God doesn't really say anything sometimes. He just let me go on. And then oftentimes he'll come back. And maybe I had to do something, or maybe I heard something, or maybe I had to go somewhere. And in my spirit, I hear the Lord asking me, you got it? Maybe I have to go to the hospital and visit the sick. Maybe I have to sit with the family that's going through bereavement. Amen. Maybe I have to do something that God put me out my way in order to do. But every time I do it, amen, all I hear is, you got it? And when we look at these two disciples, we find out that in the background, that's what Jesus was asking. Amen. You got it? When you look at what happened in Luke 19 and then going over to John, amen, 12, that's what's happening. You got it? Everything was going on, and they really couldn't see it. That's why John had to sit down with his pen, clear his throat, and then say everything, and I'm paraphrasing, that was going on that week, the disciples didn't understand it. Amen. But when you go and do what God tells you to do, amen, you may not get it the first time around, but sooner or later, you're going to get it.
That's right.
And when God manifests what he wants us to do, oftentimes we question, Lord, why you send me this way? Lord, why did you ask me to do that? You got to have faith. Amen. And knowing that God knows exactly what he's doing.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Amen. How oftentimes, how many times do we say the Lord never make a mistake? How many times do we say that the Lord, amen, has sent me here for a reason? So this morning, my brothers and my sisters, I want you to understand, we may not know exactly why and how Jesus told these two disciples to go get this coat, amen, and bring it back here. But sooner or later, we're going to get it. I want you, if you will, drop in. Amen. In the narrative, here they are. They're going to get the coat. And as they go get the coat and start untying it, lo and behold, the owner of the coat comes out and see them in the midst of stealing their coat. good God Almighty. And he didn't come out with his Glock 9. Huh? He paid good money. And here these two yahoos stealing. Ooh, it's something there. But between them untying and between him coming out, something happened in the supernatural. Simply because of what Jesus told them to do. There's some assurance in when Jesus tells you to do something. He's already handled it. Do I have a witness? He's already made a way out of no way. Do I have a witness? Amen. And based on what he told them to say when somebody tried to stop them, amen, didn't realize it was going to be the owner. But when the owner came out and said, "What y'all doing? That's mine." The power in the words that came out of their mouths transcended from the power of the mouth of Jesus. And that's why oftentimes we got to say, if Jesus said it, I believe it, and that's enough. They looked to the owner and said, the master, the Lord, have need of it. That's all they had to say, because something came over the owner of the donkey. Amen. He didn't realize it, but good God Almighty, Jesus was saying, you got it? The Lord has need of it. But you got to go on further into the narrative and see exactly what happened. We already know what happened when Jesus, amen, was waiting for the donkey, and these two men came with the donkey. The scripture says that they threw their coats on the donkey. And then there was others, amen, who took the coats off of them and laid it in front of the donkey. Amen. But John says that in everything that was happening, the disciples did not understand why it was happening until Jesus was glorified. Now, folk would say you can stop right there, but no, that glorification, amen, come when Jesus hung on the cross. That glorification came when Jesus was laid in a borrowed tomb. That glorification came when Jesus got up with all power in his hands. You got it? You may not understand what the Lord is doing to you now, but sooner or later you're going to find out, I got it. Do I have a witness? Amen. Do you have what these two disciples have? Amen. Do you understand that there has to be obedience in what God have us to do? Don't stop. Don't pick up $200. Just go head on and do what the Lord say do. Do I have a new one? Because, amen, when you do what the Lord tells you to do, amen, believe you me that he won't take you to it unless you get through it. And he'll get you through it. Do I have a witness? Amen. They didn't get it. They didn't have it. They didn't understand. Amen. The others didn't have it. They didn't get it. They didn't understand. But sooner or later, and start breaking off branches. And the word says that not only with their coats, but with the palm branches they put in front of the donkey, carrying the King of Kings, carrying the Lord of Lords. And then all of a sudden, somehow, some way, not only one, but the whole multitude got it. Here is Jesus, the Lamb of God. Here is Jesus, my Lord and my Savior, mounting a donkey to come down in Jerusalem. as he on his way to Calvary. And then all of a sudden there became a mob mentality. And the mob mentality looked on what was happening before them. And they realized what the prophets had said concerning this day. The prophets say that our Messiah would come riding on a donkey. Somebody had been in the temple when the priest had maybe hear this, teaching this. And all of a sudden, there was a new song written on the inside of their hearts. Do I have a witness? Have you ever been in a position to where the Lord will give you a new song? Maybe the song might not be new, but maybe it's been sung before. I need you to understand that when the Lord gives you a song to sing, you got to sing it and knowing that God will hear and answer your prayer. Somebody maybe been started humming it and then heard the melody of it. But good God Almighty, maybe one caught it and then another one heard it. But at the end of the day, they started singing the same song. Hosanna! Hosanna! Do I have a witness? Hosanna!
Hosanna!
The King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Rose of Sharon, the Balm in Gilead, was riding as a lowly king, coming into Jerusalem. What's he coming for? He's coming because I need saving. Why is he coming? He's coming because I need life.
Come on, Reverend.
Why is he coming? He's coming because, good God Almighty, I need salvation. Hosanna! Hosanna! Praise God, he's coming. And I need to ask somebody, do you got it? Do you understand why he came? The way he came. Do you understand why he came? He came just for me. Mm-hmm. Just for me. All with my baggage, he came for me. Everything that he wanted me to do, he came for me.
He came.
But the key is, it's not the parade, but it was happening, what happened in the parade. Everybody was praising the Lord. And you know, you got to always have those who going to try to stop you. But the word says that the Pharisees who saw what was happening, you know they didn't have it. They went to Jesus and asked Jesus, why your disciples are crying out. They wanted him to stop them because it was too much for them. And they asked Jesus, told Jesus, shut them up. Make him be quiet. But here it is. They didn't have it.
Oh, Lord.
The disciples didn't have it. And a lot of the multitudes didn't have it.
Yeah.
And they want Jesus to make them be quiet. But good God Almighty, when you got Jesus on the inside, when you know that you know that you know,
Yeah.
If it had not been for Jesus on my side,
yeah, Lord,
where would I be?
Come on, Reverend.
And Jesus looked around and saw what was happening. And Jesus said, if these don't praise me, the rocks are going to cry out. Is there anybody here this morning who really got it?
Yeah.
Who really understand that Jesus is the Lord of Lords.
Yeah.
And the King of Kings.
Yeah.
And Jesus is moving into the Jerusalem to tear up some things, to change the direction of some things, to shift some things.
Yeah.
I need you to understand that Jesus said, if these don't praise me, the rocks are going to cry out.
Yeah, Lord.
I don't know about you this morning.
I want no rock.
I don't need no rocks.
Yeah.
Crying out for me.
Preach, Reverend.
I'm not gonna let the rocks cry out for me.
Hallelujah.
He's brought me this far.
Yeah.
He's brought me the way.
Woo! He brought me.
I got it.
He brought me.
Took you up from your sick bed. I got
it. He brought me.
Put food on your table. I got it.
He brought me.
Clothes on your back. I got it.
I got it.
He's good.
I got it.
He's good.
I got it.
Yeah. He's good.
Yeah, I got it.
I got it.
Yeah.
I got it.
I got it.
Thank you, Lord.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord. I got it. I got it. I got it. I got it.
Amen.
They were singing Hosanna. Oh, I got it. Why do you sing? I heard the songwriter. I sing because I'm happy. I sing because I'm free. Woo! I sing because He has his eyes.
His eyes.
I'm singing because of what he can do.
The sparrow.
Uh-huh. And for what I know he's going to do.
He watches.
Yeah, he does. Yeah, he does.
Oh, he watches. Woo.
He.
Don't you know that I sing?
Stand on your feet. I'm through. Stand on. I got it.
Because it makes me happy.
He makes me happy.
I sing. Because I'm free. Don't you know that I sing?
I sing
because I'm happy.
The doors of the church are open.
Don't you know that I sing?
I sing.
Because
put those hands together.
I'm free.
Anybody in the
house? Oh, God's eyes.
God's eyes.
Are on the sparrow. And I know, he watches over me. Don't you know that
I sing.
Because I'm happy. Don't you know that I sing? I sing because I'm free. His eyes are on the sparrow. I know he watches me. Come on, give God praise. Hallelujah.
If you ain't got it by now, you'll never get it.
Reach, Reverend.
Hallelujah. But I need to tell somebody, if you don't know, you better ask somebody. Amen. He is God. He is God all by himself. Amen. We have a note to lift up in prayer, Sister and Brother Johnson. Amen. Keep them in our prayers. Whatever the situation may be, we know God will hear and answer our prayers. Amen. And we thank God for what he's about to do. Amen. In that situation. We thank God for what he has done, for what he is going to do. Amen. We know that God can do anything but fail. Amen. Let us now prepare to worship the Lord with that of our giving. Amen. Because we know that the Lord, amen, loves a cheerful giver. Amen. A cheerful giver. Not one who holds back and squeeze their gift in their hand and give it grudgingly. But he likes and loves a cheerful giver. Amen. How many of you know you really can't beat God's giving? Amen. No matter how you try. But experience shows me that oftentimes people don't try to outgive God. Amen. They just don't want to give, period. But we who are born again Christians and true followers of our Lord and Savior Jesus the Christ, we know that he has taught us it's better to give than to receive. Amen. Let us pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you for these who have come to Heavenly Father, not to just worship you in spirit and in truth, in emotions, but have come to worship you with their tithes and their offerings. Lord, we thank you, dear God, that we don't have to cut and stab and cut into a sheep, amen, to bring our sacrifices and our offerings to you. God, we know that you look on what we do and you have blessed us based on our faith. And so therefore you just ask to come and bring it. So here we are, dear Heavenly Father, to bring our tithes and our offerings. Our feeble means of saying thank you, Lord. And our feeble means of saying I do have hope. Our feeble means in saying, Lord, use me. Amen. I'll go. Bless the gift and the giver, we pray. Let it go forth for the uplifting of your kingdom and certainly for the ministry of this, your church. In Jesus' name we do pray. Amen and amen.
Lord, if you don't do it, it just won't be done. So Lord, do it for me.
Yes.
Sometimes I get desperate and I say like this, I say, Lord, fix it for me. Anybody know that only God can do it? Oh, fix it for me. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Because, Lord, I have a problem that only you can solve. So, Lord, do it for me.
Can y'all play that for me?
We want the DJ to keep playing that song so we can get down into our spirits. Amen. Hallelujah.
Fix it for me.
Fix it for me.
Anybody know God can do it?
Yes, Lord.
Oh, Jesus, fix it for me.
Fix it, fix it, fix it for me. My.
Lord, I have a problem.
Anybody know that?
I need you to do it for me.
Woo! Hallelujah.
Everybody say it right now. Say, Lord.
Yes, yes. Do you need him to do something for you? My.
If you need God to do something, say, Lord. Do it.
Do it. Thank you, Lord.
Pray
over me, heal. Whether misunderstanding, bring peace. Whether there be those who may be lost and don't know what Jesus can do for them, save them. Somebody need to be delivered in the name of Jesus. Lord, let it be done right now. Lord, whatever you're doing, don't do it without us. In Jesus' name, amen. As the deacons come, amen, and give out, we ask that those who family members, one for each family if you can, amen. We thank God for it, amen. And while they are handing those out, I want to announce, amen, that on next Thursday, there will not be, amen, next Thursday, there will not be a Bible Academy session because on Friday, on Friday, Good Friday, we'll be worshiping the Lord here in our Good Friday, amen, worship experience at 7 o'clock. Amen. A good friend of ours, amen, Reverend Kirby will be the guest speaker. So please, ma'am, please, sir, invite all of those who you can to come and be a part of our Good Friday worship experience. Amen. Also on this year, we have the anniversary offering being $145 per family. Please, ma'am, please, sir, govern yourselves accordingly. And on next Sunday morning, we have the lesson coming from Acts chapter 6, verses 7 through 15, concerning living in faith. Amen. Living in faith. So we ask that all of you, amen, do not have a commentary as of yet. I think the commentaries are in, and make sure you get one as well. Amen. Amen. We want to thank, huh? Did it today. Amen. God bless you. All right. All right. Amen. We also want to thank Reverend Evans for doing our lesson this morning. Give her a hand. Amen. Job well. Well done. Amen. Amen. And amen. Amen. Well, we are about to leave. If there's no other business that has to be mentioned, amen. Let's get ready to prepare, amen, to leave. Stand to your feet. Amen. Again, we want to thank God for what it's about to do from today all the way through Sunday. And when you read the account, you'll find out that every day is accounted for into what he's going to do. Amen. Today he went through Jerusalem, and then as he had the parade ended, he goes into the temple. Amen. And he looks that the temple is being desecrated, and he turns over the money changers. He kicks the table. Amen. Somebody said, Jesus got mad. Well, you don't know. Jesus got mad. Amen. Because they were turning the house of God, amen, into something it was not supposed to be. Amen. And we say, thank you, Lord. Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come now asking you, O gracious God, to do what you do. We come now, O God, saying, Lord, whatever you need me to do, here I am, simply because I got it. I know why now you did what you did, when you did it, and how you did it. And now, Lord, I pray that you just carry me along, bring me along, amen, into the fold. Make sure that I'm part of what you're doing in this world, making your kingdom here on earth as it is in heaven. So, Father, as we prepare and commence this holy week, we ask, O gracious God, that your name will be lifted up. Amen. And that your glory will be filled. Have your blessed way with these, your people. God, bless them according to their faith and what they need. Now, God, as we prepare to leave this place, but never from your presence, we ask, oh God, that you go with us. Hold us. Prop us on every leaning side, we pray. And God, when it's all said and done, we're going to give you all the glory, all the praise. That's going to be your holy and your righteous name. It is in Jesus' mighty, magnificent, precious name we do pray. Amen, amen, and amen. God bless you. Go in peace. Have a blessed week. Hallelujah.